seed. Fifth thing is jala, that is the water. These things are the five components of food. Food is not a separate component. Food is a conglomeration of these five components. Water, earth, then soil, that is earthy soil. The surface of the earth is known as land and the substance of earth is known as soil. Somebody asked me this question. What is earth, what is land and what is soil? Earth is the crust, surface is the land and substance is the soil. So likewise, first is the land, soil or earth, whatever it may be, bhu. Second is water. Third thing is deru. Fourth thing is rishabha. Fifth thing is the bija, the seeds. There are the five components. So we have to take a collective or a holistic view of this food. So this thing is possible only by us. So we have three specialities. Having a whole structured focus of food is with us. Number two, apart from mere food productivity, lack of austerities and principles of food consumption, ethics of food consumption, it is known as food ethics or consumptive ethics, it is that developed by us, number one. Number two, number three. Number one, I already told, holistic view. Second thing is consumptive ethics. Third thing is food as a panacea for everything, for health, wealth, prosperity, harmony, universal peace, prevention from disasters, everything can be organized only through food, easily through food, rather than radar and satellite predictions and other mechanical and technological these things. So next session, certainly we will need an elaborated session, whereby if I am having a board, I think that I can talk very slowly, I can write things, you can note down, 1 or 2 hours it will take, you will learn less, but you will learn. Now you are hearing, you are not learning. Hearing is different from learning. So if I conduct a class, teaching is different from lecturing. Lecture means to make you know what is there in the shastras. And teaching is make you know what you have known. That I have to do the next time at least. So make your blackboard and chalk is available or a marker available. 2 hours we can take class with question and answers. And it will not be with mic, everything at all. Everything I will write, then you can rewrite. Very slowly we can do. I believe that this also should have. There are a lot of home science colleges like Avinash Lingam College. Lot of home science colleges are there. Wherever they are having a BSc in food nutrition and dietetics they are having. But we should develop BSc in onto dietetics. That deals with feast. How to conduct feast? Why to conduct feast? By conducting feast, we are getting three things. One is evil eye. We are getting three apacharas. If you distribute food to all people, do you think that they are all flattering you? They will put their envious eyeball on you. You will get lot of envy, hostility, and lot of jealousy and partiality from those people. Lot of evil things are brought in feasting. It is not like that. All people are not like-minded. That is there. Secondly, criminal wastage of food. In all feasts, certainly these things are unavoidable. Criminal wastage of food. Third thing, food does not reach the people who are in need of that. Those who don't deserve that. Let it be saad or prasad. Saad should go to the people who are hungry for food and prasad should go to the people who are thirsty for divine union. Prasad should go for the divine thirsty. And those who are belly hunger, those who are affected with belly hunger, for them they should go. Either a spiritual hunger or biological hunger, they should be fed with saad and prasad. This feast, none of the people are so much deserving. So it gives you evil eye, it gives with our compatibility, incompatibility with the deservingness. Third thing is criminal wastage, nasha, anna nasha. So by doing this feast, we are only enjoying the ill benefits, we are not getting any benefits at all. So we are purchasing sins and sorrows by spending thousands of rupees and feeding people. Spending 50,000 rupees, we are purchasing sufferings with 40% discount. That is what we are doing there. So, onto dietetics, I have already told, it deals with food. What is food? What is feast? What is the systemic scientific study of fasting? What is the systemic scientific study of offering? What is cultivation? What is distribution? That is government distribution, public distribution services, agencies, research, etc. What is distribution? What is nutrition? Really, what do we mean by nutrition? What is real dietetics? And what is real vegetarianism? I have already told, vegetarianism is not only taking vegetables, taking prescribed vegetables is vegetarianism. Taking any vegetable, it is not vegetarianism. For example, shikaka is also coming from a tree. Can we take that? It is not like that. Vegetarianism, you should be selective where to take, what to take like that. So, I think that Sujata Vidya, already I have discussed about a lot of topics like that. But still, as it is very much formal, I know that today this century is not only India century, it is a century for the people to understand about the ethics of handling food, air and water, I have already told. without which there won't be any century at all. There will be nobody to record the century after 200 years. So you have to learn that autodidact if we do from India, from this intellectual city of Pune, especially from the Supra Research founder, especially from the India International Multiversity, certainly it will be a pride and honor and a crown to all of us. It will be an enthronement to all of our endeavors. It will be a divine sanction to all of our tireless efforts that we have done throughout various decades. We have been doing that. So I believe that next session will be more elaborative, and BSc or MSc, at least let us start with even diploma. We are applying for a diploma now. Let it be a diploma course for 3 months in ontodiatrics. So this is the end of today's lecture. I think that we have productively ended this lecture by allowing us to get into a very big royal pathway of getting the imminent possibilities of immanent wisdom or immense wisdom. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.